NBA 2K22 is $20. It has been approximately 216 days since the game has dropped, and 149 days until the next 2K, if it happens on September 10th. We're over the 50% mark of the year being over for 2K22, and the game has went down more than, oh my goodness, bro, the game has went down more than 50%. 2K has had to drop their prices from $60 to $20 because of the lack of people buying the game. Everyone's excited for the game. First day, first launch, you know what I'm saying? We're going to play the new part, pro-am, see what the new badges look like, seeing the new rep system, jump shots, whatever the case may be. Everyone's hyped first, two, three fucking week or month. But after that first month, after September ends, bro, that shit is drier than the Sahara Desert. Everyone's already figured out the gameplay, the thing, that, and there's really nothing new to do, no reason to play. Because sometimes the gameplay rewards are just not the best, so if you're not going to grind for the gameplay rewards, there's really no point to play. And then we'll slowly get off the game and play other games. And some people, based on other people's opinions, they might not even get the game. And if 2K is not selling the game out, because they still have to make bread, bro, they're going to lower the prices to see if they can pull more customers in to get their game at a lower price. Come to find out, 216 days later, it would be valued at fucking $20, bro. That's 2 5-piece pizzas and 3 McChickens at McDonald's, bro. And we're not even counting the Cokes, bro. That entire meal with the Coke is already more than the game itself. That shit is just crazy. When we search up GameStop, go to it and type in NBA 2K22. My guy, bro, what? We know these are pre-owned, but like, fuck, bro. A brand new PlayStation game is $20. It's not even 20, bro, it's 19, bro. They still got Mikey Williams on the cover. This man's like, fuck, bro. Let me just take my bag real quick. For the Nintendo Switch, that bitch is 20. For the PlayStation 5, 20. Xbox, 20. And PS4, 20, bro. This shit is fucking crazy. And y'all might be like, Noel, it's only fucking GameStop. You go to Best Buy. Hold the fuck up. Can this shit load? And then we look up NBA 2K22. $20 fucking, bro. Was 40, but the game was good. At the very beginning, before we found out all the fucking shit wrong with it, the game was good. And I'm not gonna lie, bro, these prices accurately depict on like the game itself. The game is really, it's not horrible, but there's definitely many reasons why this game is not high valued right now. Fucking at Target, that bitch is 20. Walmart, that bitch is 20. Bro, I'm not gonna lie, bro, some places even have it less than 20, they have like a 19. And on Steam, they have that bitch at 60. You're finessing your customers. I'm not gonna lie to y'all boys. What the fuck? And I'm paying this game 216 days after this shit came out. And Amazon also has it as like around 20. Normally, sports games, obviously, through the years, they do decrease in price because obviously the new one comes out. The new game hasn't even came out. It's at $20, but most games are like this. Why is that most games decrease? This shit, at the end of the day, bro, I'm a fan of 2K. I play that game. The game is extremely repetitive, and in this case of NBA 2K22, the rewards are extremely not good and not top tier. For example, the rewards. This is Season 6, but again, since they wanted to do the level 40 reward, we should be getting rewards every single season that are pretty good, I'm not gonna lie. Most of these rewards are pretty mid. I mean, these banners are kind of gas, but it's a banner, you feel me? What the fuck is this? You feel me? What? Bro, what is this, bro? This looks like a fucking melted Sour Patch Kid, like what the hell? And then we go to the very end and it's a bunny suit. We're in Season 6, 260 days, and they gave us a bunny suit. The rewards this year just have not been that valid. I'm gonna keep it a bean with y'all. They have not gave us an NBA mascot this year. The rewards been slacking, boys, but all y'all boys already knew that. The overall park design, bro, y'all boys know this shit is sexy. Even if you just don't like 2K, bro, you gotta admit this shit is sexy. They did a good job with fucking making the park design fucking amazing. Each season, they brought out a new design, and I'm not gonna lie, this is the best part of NBA 2K22, which is way better than any other game when it comes to the park designs, bro. You can tell they actually put effort and actually tried. But there's a lot of other things in this game that just seem like they just really didn't care. For example, bro, there's a bunch of glitches in this game. Way too many fucking glitches. For the clothes, if you go to clothes, see, look at this, bro. Shit doesn't appear. Exactly, shit doesn't appear. Shit doesn't appear. Clothes glitch, that's a big ass glitch right there. But one of my biggest problems with NBA 2K22. Woo! Come on, boys. You have to go to that game right over there and keep filtering in parks and stages to get park games if you want to play on the ones court, bro. Look, bro, You know what I'm saying? We're not trying to be here 10 years on some real shit, though. We neither need another one score, another two. You know what I'm trying to say? Like, this game has some bugs, deficiencies. Shit's kind of sketch, I'm gonna be honest. But at the end of the day, each game, regardless of what it is, Madden, 2K, FIFA, you know what I'm trying to say? Like, they're all gonna have glitches and things that we would want to change. And most of the time, the developers do a good job at trying to cover all the problems so each consumer and customer is happy. But, especially in the 2K scenario, it's just kind of tough. The game's just been very repetitive, bro. Ever since, 14 or 15, when they first introduced Park, we have that shit for 8 or 9 years. 8 or 9 years of playing the same 3v3, 2v2. You know what I'm trying to say? That shit's gonna get repetitive. And no matter what they bring to us, they can make us fucking the baddest bitches as a fucking level 40 reward, and some of y'all will still not play it for the simple fact that this shit is just boring and repetitive because of the nature of how long we've been playing it. Something that 2K might be able to do to make sure the game is not going down in price this much, obviously I ain't no marketing. You feel me? They do whatever they want to do. But, my God, bring a competitive game mode. Bring a ranked system so we can play against the best Park players in the world, rank up against them, and possibly become one to unlock cash money prizes similar to Fortnite. Because, bro, they're competitive, say Fortnite. Competitive is Fortnite. And if competitive can be 2K, 2K can become top tier. You know what I'm trying to say? Shit can go crazy. Shit can go really fun. And that is why NBA 2K22 is $20. Hope you guys enjoyed. I'll see y'all boys in the next one, and I'm out. Peace! Love y'all boys, and subscribe.